Good afternoon, gamers. Whoa. Feels like we missed a day, didn't it? Listen, I'll be real with you. I'm a piece of shit. Hey, didn't I unlock Moraccio at one point? Like, accidentally? Did that not go through when I did that on accident? Just realizing? Now? Huh. Hey, what are we doing today? You know what? I'm thinking Bonaporta here. She got the port. I assume that's a woman's name, Porta. Well, let's unlock. Yeah, that looks like Arca, but with titties. Yeah, so we'll do Porta to kind of get us going here. Sorry if I'm feeling a little... I think I'm starting this one real weird already. What's hyper, by the way? Don't look at things. Gold bonus. Move speed bonus. Huh. I assume there's also other drawbacks to that, so I will. Oh my god. Oh, what? That already just... Hello? It just starts doing that? Well, I've got an amount plus one. His cooldown is heavily reduced. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Cool. I'm gonna take knife too. Oh my god. This is sort of disgusting already. Oh my. Well, good start, I guess. Hey, how's everyone doing? It's Monday. This is a Monday episode. You know, I just got home. Well, just a couple hours, whatever. I just got home from watching. Oh, hello, the cat's here. The new One Piece movie. And I have some thoughts. And I think that the movie has some very good. It gives us a lot of new information about certain pieces of lore. But other than that, well, hold on. Also, the music was really good. Yeah, the music was really good. But other than that, it was like, it was okay. It was an okay movie, but a pretty good concert. I actually watched the dub, which is unusual for me. Hollow Heart becomes something that I don't know. Or I do know. What is Hollow Heart? I don't remember. I'm gonna take it. Was it whip? Hollow Heart. It is whip, and I don't know what it makes. Okay, good to know. So anyways, as I was saying, very good movie. Not very good movie. Very good concert. Okay movie. And I just feel like that's kind of having how the movies have been recently. I had my hopes up. Stampede was not that good either. Stampede was like a... I don't know. I felt like a fan wrote it. You know? I was just glad that... Okay, so One Piece Film Red. Obviously, all the movies tend to be like, hey, here's characters that you remember from previous. And I actually wish they would stop doing that in general. I think the last... good one was Gold, in my opinion. And Gold has very, very few characters from like the main show. They're mostly like, I'm gonna focus up a little bit here. They're mostly cameos, like appear in the background. Like they're just there having a good time. Trafalgar has been a weirdly pivotal part of both Stampede and Red. Where it's just like, what are you doing here, man? At least, like, Red had a reason. Stampede, he was just like, yeah, I'm here. And you're like, what? Why are you here? I was just glad that Sabo didn't show up again. And not that I don't like Sabo. I'm sorry. I'm talking about One Piece only. If you don't like One Piece, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. You're in the wrong place. Although I am mostly avoiding spoilers. Other than for the movies themselves. Lightning Ring, again, would be cool. I won't talk about it too much, I suppose. But anyway, this movie was okay. I really do wish they would get back to the movies having unique characters, is mostly what I wanted to say. And also, as much as I love Otto and the music was fantastic, it was just a concert, essentially. And I saw that complaint from Japanese viewers as well. And then just a lot of weird lore drop about Shanks. And you're just like, I guess. I mean, whatever. Also, I guess big spoiler here. Skip the next 30 seconds if you don't want to be big spoiled. The animation of Gear 5 was pretty nice. Very, very short, very subtle. Pretty good. Anyways, I'm done. No more One Piece talk. Unless we talk about... I've actually considered, I don't really think I will anytime soon, but I would like to do like a, some sort of, not review of One Piece, but just sort of like a chat about One Piece, like on a stream kind of thing. I might do, I kind of want to do like tier lists at some point also, if that makes sense, you know what I mean? I have pretty odd opinions about some things sometimes, and sometimes very, what's the word I'm looking for? Passionate opinions about weird things. And sometimes I see other people's tier lists and I go, oh boy, I could do that differently. But I gotta find like some good tier lists. Like, a big one is I really want to do a pizza chain tier list, because I have my own specific tier rating for pizzas, because there is I'll kind of break it down for you right now. There's low tier pizzas and there's mid tier pizzas and there's high tier pizzas, obviously. But the problem is that there are mid tier pizzas that are not very good. So a bad mid-tier pizza is much worse than a good low-tier pizza. So, for an example, I would call Pizza Hut a mid-tier pizza, but it's not a good mid-tier pizza. So, a pizza that knows it's not that good, like, say, Little Caesars or Hungry Howie's, those are actually not bad, because if you go in knowing I'm getting a low tier pizza, I'm paying for a low tier pizza. Pizza Hut, you're paying for a mid tier pizza and you're getting what is arguably, in my opinion, worse than some low tier pizzas. So it's just bad. It's the worst that you could probably do. Red gem. Thank you so much. But meanwhile, there are high tier, mid tier pizzas. So, like, Papa John's is a high-tier, mid-tier. It's pretty good. Marco's is a high-tier, mid-tier. And then there's, like, then there's high-tier. Like, Mellow Mushroom or, like Rosati's is, like, you know. That's a high-tier. And my high-tier, I think the base tier is based off of price in particular. If that makes sense. So... obviously, like a high tier, you know, Mellow Mushroom is like, that's like, you're going and spending 25, 30 bucks on all pot, you know? And then it's pretty good. So I feel like it really breaks down into my high tiers. I don't know personally of a high tier that I would call bad, that I would compare down to a mid tier even. So really, it just goes. It goes low, low tier, and then it goes low, mid tier, and then it goes high, low tier. This probably makes no fucking sense. And then it goes high, mid tier. Is that right? Did I get that right? Did I get my own thing right? Is spinach paired with anything? I don't remember. I forget. Do we know if the clock does? I don't think so. We still need to try and pay. I want to try and get whip. So I want to see what that makes. Probably didn't make any sense. The pizza tier list. I need to work it out on paper. That's what I want to do one day. Just work that out on paper. And then find a bunch of like... I want to do like a month-long process where I try multiple pizza places and I rank them based on price and quality. And then I make my official Treish pizza tier list. Ah, these guys are chasing, dude. I don't love my shit right now. You know what I mean? I don't love it. Just, I really gotta get some better stuff at the moment. And I feel like I'm I'm running out of the time where I can start. Oh, ooh, clover. I'm running out of the time where I can continue to rant about pizza and I need to actually focus on the game. Because I don't have like a kit that I would like right now. Hey, you know what? Go ahead and comment. What's your favorite pizza place? And the thing is I live in, I think I've tried most of the like chain pizzas in my area. But of course I'm limited, you know, not everything's around here. I think that's like I'd look at like national chains only. Or, you know, mostly national chains. I feel like it's not like, you know how, let's grab whip before we forget. But you know how like, you can't get Jack in the Box or Whataburger anywhere. Are there pizza chains like that? I feel like pizza chains are like national only. Like obviously Pizza Hut you can get. You know, I will say, I don't think Rosati's is everywhere. But like that's sort of, it's still, I would call a national chain, you know, where it's like, hey, it's around, obviously. You're like, yeah, okay. I don't want a clover because I have plus 20% on whatever already. I would rather just keep getting stuff I have upgraded. We haven't seen a chest yet, by the way. I only just realized that because I have the plus one to quantity, whip is good all the time now. Hey, a chest. I used to say, oh, it's bad. I used to say that whip was only, I'm fucking upsetty spaghetti here. Let me, Rue, you need to get powered up fast. We're, The Bone Brigade's coming soon. I think it's like 12 minutes. Anyways, what was I saying? I used to say that the whip was bad because... Yay, we got a triple right off the bat. Because it started as just the one. So if you start with whip, like with the first guy or whatever his name was, then you obviously... the next one you get is gonna have two, and you're like, okay. But I one time was playing without, you know, having whip, and I was like, I'm not gonna pick up whip because it just starts with one, starts bad, and I don't want to start bad. I want to start good. I want the first whip I pick up to make it good. Is it three now? It's three now. That's pretty cool. Oh, let's slide on through here. Actually, heyo. I like the whip with three. It doesn't really make sense, but I like it. How he whipping three times? Alright, that's true. That's true. Good visual representation there. Yeah, you got it. There's another chest, I think. Is that what that is? Yeah. I'm just gonna hop back into the circle real quick here. You know, grab that boy. What you got for me? Let me drink some water. Oh, daggers. Is that fully upgraded now? No. Why did I think that was higher? mean, it's not. So. I want the duplicator ring. I'd like to get the lightning storm again. Yo, give me that. Give me them flaming hot Cheetos. Yes, especially now that the Bone Brigade is here. Good call. Alright, cool. I think we're boning. We're fighting off the Bone Brigade pretty well here. I really would like a Tract Orb. Because I feel like we got a lot of stuff just sitting around other places right now. This doesn't need to be leveled up. But you know what, it can be, I suppose. It doesn't have to be to get the whip item. It just whip has to be. But you know, it's never that bad to have. Doesn't suck. I don't want to stray too far. I think things despawn eventually when you move away. I'd rather come back through and try and grab some of my valuable left behind items. Ooh, there's a thing. What do you mean there? Whoa! I feel like the lightning ring is, like, not working the same way anymore. Is it still striking? I just feel like I'm not noticing it. Hey, there's lightning ring. Speak and you shall be granted your wish. It is level 8.
What?
I didn't realize I had it that high, actually. Alright, you know what? I'm paying a little more attention. It's definitely doing some work. Oh, right. We gotta deal with this now. I'm gonna get Clock Lancet again. Oh, are we in one of these old boys? No, just two quick ones. Every time I get two quick ones, I think that I'm... Ooh, yeah, I'll freeze time. Yeah. Give me a moment to, like, come up here, grab some of these. That's good eats. That's good eats. Let's stick to, like, Bracer. Good eats, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at all these monies. Look at all these ranchos. I will take the knife because I... Because that's another thing, actually, good point. Bracer doesn't need to be leveled, but knife does to get its bonus item. It's super duper special, awesome, cool item. Okay, stop time again, I guess. Just obliterated that werewolf. That one's mid-obliteration. Do you see him? He's like Spider-Man at the end of Infinity War.
Mr. Belpasse, I don't feel so good.
I know that I'm not even playing as a Belpasse right now. Hollow knife. Almost said hollow heart.
Oh, this is a bad time to be me. I'm gonna fucking die. Oh, God.
Sorry. Oh, my God, please. Ooh, the ghosts. I mean, really, the werewolves are the problem. The ghosts I kill pretty quickly. The werewolves, not so much. Ooh, gimme, cheeky. Ooh, charge me up, Jolly Ranchers. Ooh. Okay. This could give us nothing, actually. We don't have any currently set up. Yeah. Life is close, right? Now, it's definitely close. And now it's 8. Alright, we're okay. We're okay. I'll take the spinach. So, how does... Okay, cool chicken. I fucked that up immediately. Sorry, I'm in brain mode. I gotta start, like, I can't sit here and talk about One Piece all day or pizza or whatever. I gotta. Okay, we're okay. We're okay. Oh, give me that chicken. See, we're almost at full health. That's all according to Keikaku. Oh, Lord. Oh, God. Oh. There's so many gems over there, but I can't reach them. I'm barely, like, scooting through. Come on, come on. Oh, I see it. 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 I don't need that. I don't know why I would go for that. Gimme, 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 gimme. I don't know that I want to take Pentagram right now. Oh, Lord in heaven. Ooh. Armor would not suck right now. I will be honest with you. I don't think there was a... No, 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 no. I'm dead, I'm dead, I'm dead, I'm dead, I'm dead, I'm dead, I'm dead. That sucked. It wasn't good. It was not good. Go again. Porta, let's not piss up, dude. Don't fuck me, Porta. You start off doing that shit, man. I mean, they literally appear on screen and they're dead. I feel like that's not always spawning gems. Wand also. Oh my god, that heavily goes, huh? Wow, that's already going. I don't even know if I upgraded cooldown that much or if that's like part of her. I wouldn't mind Cross. It's Cross. Cross does pair with something that I don't have yet. Yeah, but Cross right now with like this cooldown stuff and like it do kind of go hard, I think. Like, just look at it. It's already zip-zopping away. If we could get bracers, get the speed up higher, get, you know, a duplicator ring, still would like that. If we'd had a dang old duplicator ring, we would have had the hey, there we go. We would have had the, like, thunder ring or whatever. Thunder loop, that's what it's called. Elon Musk's thunder loop. What is that stupid thing called? What is he calling it? It's something loop, isn't it? It's definitely something loop. I just don't remember, like... Hyperloop! I remembered it. It's Hyperloop. Yeah, Elon owns Twitter now, huh? I don't remember if that was a thing when I last recorded. Candelabrador, I'm sorry. I don't know. Dick Lightning Ring. Ooh, wait. Investment. I don't know. I think people are a little too doomsday on the Twitter thing, but, like, I do think there are, problems with the verification, being purchasable. I think that there was, pretty good reasons for verification sometimes, but people started to, in fact, use it more like a cool kid club badge, but really it should just be used for properly identifying certain people. But I think that at the same time should have been something that anyone could have probably applied for. You know, in the same way that I use, I think it's Bumble that does it. Bumble has a, it's simple. It just goes, hey, post a picture of you doing some sort of hand symbol, and it checks, like, is this you? Are you doing the right symbol? And then it goes, okay, And so, like, I'm not saying it doesn't necessarily have to be that simple, but... And I do know that, like, he did say something about if you pay for the verification, it'll put, like, some sort of tag underneath your thing that goes, like, this is so-and-so. But I still just think that it's asking people to pay for it as if it's more like a cool kids club badge. And I just think that that's ill-advised. I also think it was so funny. People that already had the check mark changing their, like, you know, Twitter name to be Elon Musk. Not actually changing their handle, but just their name. And jokingly impersonating him, saying things like, "Ah, oh, I love waking up and drinking my own piss and shit." I thought that, and then those accounts getting like banned, and other people going, "Man, I thought he tweeted that comedy was allowed on Twitter again." And now today he's like, "If you're not specifically a parody account and you try to impersonate somebody, you will be indefinitely banned." And I'm like, oh boy, here comes this dictator Elon, you know. And I'm sure it's just gonna be, you know, his excuse to get rid of people making fun of him specifically. But ain't none of my business. My only problem is that it looks like, I guess another thing he mentioned in a investor meeting was that if you don't have the badge, you'll see content from people with the badge before you see content with people without the badge. And because of that, there are a lot of like artists that I follow that are really like wary and are trying to figure out where to go instead of Twitter, which is a bummer because that's specifically what I use Twitter for. It's just to see cool art of characters that I like, and like, or people's, you know, original characters too. I like that a lot. So yeah, it's the only reason I can see myself in particular leaving Twitter is if the things that I enjoy seeing on Twitter leave Twitter because they don't feel that it's a good site anymore. I personally have absolutely no problems with anything so far. I'm not spending the $8 on Twitter Blue or getting verified or anything. Like, I do not care. I also enjoyed, actually, was because Twitter has that, like, that fact check kind of filter thing, and it'll put a little blurb underneath a tweet if it's like untrue. And it was doing that with some of the ones that were like pretending to be Elon. It was like, "This is not Elon, it's Chris Warcraft, and he's changed his name to Elon Musk." And you're like, "Yeah, obviously I knew that, but like, sure, I guess." And I will say, actually, almost every single time I read something and then I would go, I'm like, "What? He said that?" And then I would look and go, "Oh no." So I can fully understand that there are people who go, "What? He said that?" And then don't pay that extra second of attention to go, "Oh, it wasn't Elon that said that. It was Chris Warcraft." That's the only name I remember specifically. So I'm like, I guess, but also, people are too stupid, man. I don't know what else to say. Some people are just so dumb. They're just like, you can't take that extra second to look and go, "Oh, my bad." If I hear anything that sounds remotely weird, I spend the next 30 minutes like trying to like Google it, or like one of my managers, he tends to like bullshit a lot. And the other day we were talking about Whoppers, the candy that no one likes. He was like, "Oh, I love Whoppers." I'm like, "That's interesting." He's like, "I like the, you know, sometimes you get one that it's got like extra malt in it. It's like this weird, like kind of gummy consistency to it." And I was like, "What do you think like causes that in the malting process?" Because I'm like, and I go, "Well, because I'm not actually entirely sure what is done to create a malted candy like that." And he was like, "You don't know what malted is?" And I'm like, "No, not gonna pretend I know." And he's like, "Well, have you ever heard of the country Malta?" And I immediately went, I'm sure this has absolutely nothing to do with the country of Malta. And he was like, no, it does. And I'm like, the whole time he's going through this, like, oh, Malta was the first to create the process of malting. That's why they called it malted candy or whatever. Like, the whole time I'm just going like, that don't sound right. So of course I go back to my computer and I go, what makes malt candy, malted candies or malt vinegar malt? And it's a grain. It's a grain called malt. So I'm like, ah, okay, of course. Like, he was trying to fuck with me. And sure, in that scenario in particular, I know that he likes to try and fuck with people. But like, also, if something just doesn't sound right to people, they should just look it up instead of going, I don't know, the guy on the internet said it. It's like, yeah, it doesn't really mean anything. But that's just not how society works nowadays, does it? Not how that works. Totally a shame. My lightning kind of going pretty hard right now. Actually, I'm feeling good about this build at the moment. We're getting some good lightning in here. Like my... is that what the tome does again? So currently, we can get the super magic missile and the loop. I guess I could go for, what's it called? Oh shit, is lightning fully upgraded now? It is, I'm probably getting thunder loop right now. I'm not getting thunder loop right now. Am I wrong? Was it not? Huh, it is max, and so is my duplicator. So I'm actually surprised I didn't get the thunder loop right there. Remember that's what brought up the whole Elon conversation? Also, I should not keep talking about this, but I am. Because it's one of those things, because I also don't love to talk about things that I don't have all the facts on, but it's just I can talk about what I've viewed, at least, and seen, and found amusing. But I've also seen that he's already started to take credit for things that have been development at Twitter for a little while now. So, also kind of funny. Anyways, no more Elon talk, no more One Piece talk. What are we supposed to talk about now? The game? So I still want to try and figure out what Whip and Hollow Heart become. So I am going to take Whip. Honestly, the attract, or my, that can get higher still? My magnet is going forward. I think that might have been something that our last run was missing, was we were getting like some really long distance kills, but we had no way to pick them up. I also think that the magic missiles is going kind of hard too right now. Ooh. What? This is the 5 stack, right? Could one of the stacks give me a... Oh my god. Wow. 3 magic missiles, another cross, and a whip. That's magic missiles is done now. Wow. But that could also, in an upcoming box, essentially be my next super duper. You know what I mean? The music do go hard sometimes. I can't believe this. We're only 10 minutes into this one, but it's because we messed up the last one. At like a pretty, what were we? Almost 20 minutes, I think. Probably like 17, 18. Which is like such a bummer, because we could like essentially be done right now. So this is going to be either if I lose at this point, it'll probably be like an average length one. You'll look at it and go, hey, I think he's going to win. Or it'll be like a really long one. You'll be like, oh, I think he's going to fuck up and then win. Pentagram is so tempting still. I know it pairs with something, and I don't know what. But, like, and it scares me. Because it deletes everything. It deletes EXP. So you would, again, want something like I've got right now with the, I guess this might be a good run to take it then, wouldn't it? Huh. I don't know. Oh yeah, this is an upgrade. Thunder Loop or yeah, Scepter. Scepter of Akamoto. I don't remember what it was actually called. The Holy Wand. Holy Wand. Am I right? What does that do? Fires with no cooldown, right? Yeah. It's okay. You know, it's pretty good. It's moving. I could probably stand still a little bit, right? Oh. I probably don't want to stand still now, actually. Or maybe I really do. Maybe I want to test the might of the Holy Wand. Maybe I want to test it against the Bone Boys, the Bone Brigade. It's actually doing pretty good, especially the lightning is helping too. If I had the Thunder Loop right now, these guys would be decimated. They're kind of decimated already, but you know what I mean. They'd be extra decimated. Yeah, we're okay. I grow cat. I'm gonna go grab some orange. Whip. I'm trying to avoid garlic. Garlic's kind of a crutch for me, I've noticed. Yeah, I'll increase my range again. Oh, are we in one of the loopy loops? Ross. Whip. I don't really want any of these. I guess. I really need, what's it called? Oh, I kind of want bracers, but no, if I want whip, I need the hollow heart. I need the hollow heart. Give me hollow heart. It's not giving me the option. I'm scared I won't get the option. And then I won't be able to like, oh, see? I'll take Bible so that I have the chance of possibly getting... I'm allowed one more equipped item, man. Yeah. Give me Hollow Heart, please. I want to try that out. I want to see what it does. No. Getting dicey. No. Good lord, our pickup range is nutty. Come on, not Pumarola. Hollow Heart. I really want to try it out. I want to see what it gives me. Oh, I forgot the pickup range affects, like, chicken, too, like that. Ooh, I didn't even see I picked that up. It's got me so nervous it's not going to give it to me. Because it probably isn't. I feel like I've probably seen it a couple times and just not taken it, and now I'm regretting. It's highly likely. Can I, like, live a little through standing still during werewolves and ghosts? It looks like it. Yeah, it looks like it. Especially because I have Bible now. And we're still picking up a decent amount of them because, I mean, we have the huge pickup range. Are we? It doesn't look like our thing's going up that much. We have to be. I'm not killing them all out of our pickup range. That scares me for a second. I mean, like, the holy wand is kind of, like, going nuts. The lightning is killing things sort of in groups also. I think it strikes and hits a lot around as well. All right, give me Pumarola, please. Not Pumarola. Hollow Heart. Or I'm not going to get enough EXP for anything, apparently. What the hell, man? Ooh, there's an attractive one. I don't know how much it's going to actually give me. All right. Some stuff I hadn't picked up yet. Dude, please. Hollow heart. No hollow heart. Let's go. Hollow heart clutch, baby. What is this gonna upgrade? It can upgrade the loop, but I kind of want to see if I can, like, hang out and see if I get the last whip I need, and then I'll grab it to see if it gives me either that or the hyper loop. I'll do that, actually, because I can. Grab him. I'm glad it doesn't affect, the pickup range doesn't affect on chess. Come on, dude. Give me the whip I need. Give me that whip. You're only giving me things that I have already, so just make it the whip. Oh, things are getting a little dicey here. Whip! All right, grab it. What are we getting? It's one of them. Either Thunder Loop or whatever the whip in Hollow Heart gives me. It's Thunder Loop, which I will take because things are getting a little dicey now, and that will come in handy. I was going to say, is it going to shoot? There we go. And now we might get the other one. Ooh, moment of truth. What is it? The Hyper Whip. What's that called? Bloody Tear. Evolved Whip can deal critical damage and absorb HP. Oh. Whoa, did you just see that? Whoa. It's big, too. That's nice. I gotta say, that's nice. Look at it suck up the HP, dude. Nice. And we're still getting some cooldown reduction off of the tome. In fact, let's do that. How much does that go to? It goes to 5. And if we get the axe up, we'll get the scythes too. That worked out really well right at the end there. Oh, this is going hard. Home again. Tome away from tome. Oh man. Woo. Nice, we like axe. Scythe is so much better than Axe, in my opinion, though. Look at Axe go, though. It kind of do go hard. With cooldown reduction, it's not bad. What is our cooldown reduction at right now? Fucking minus 34%. Wait, wasn't it higher earlier? Wasn't it like minus 60%? Do I not understand how cooldown reduction works? Yeah. I mean, at this point, we're going to get everything max. So it doesn't really matter what I select. It's going to be...
look at everything go, man.
I still don't know what cross fuses with. I get the hollow heart, and then I fill it up almost immediately. I get two more hollow hearts. That's the whip upgrade is really good, honestly. I like that a lot. It's like a less crutch version of the advanced guard, you know? Oh yeah, give me all that. That's juicy. And everything's become real sparse again, so like everything's getting hit with Oh, what did I just hit? What did I just do? Oh, I must have gotten like the cross. Hollow heart again, please. So I'll essentially have
fucking hell, 230 max health right now?
And I get one more hollow heart? Holy crap. Literally meant nothing. I could have just not done that. I'm amazed at like how sparse the battlefield gets when the mummies come in. Not bad. But like I can also decimate them, so it could give me more, I guess. I mean, look at that. We have how many special items? We only have three, actually, with potential of a fourth, but like also we have pretty good stats. I'm gonna kill that bat. See that little bat? It's dead. It's still alive, actually. There we go. What you got for me, boy? Whoa, another Bible. Praise Jeebus. Another Bible. Doesn't matter. I should just be just hitting A. I've got all everything. I should just keep just going. I could probably stand still again, but it just doesn't make for good content, you know? Man. There's the little mummies and the big mummies coming now. Don't know why I keep looking at it like I need to decide something. Yeah, it's kind of nutty. Like, I just sort of barreling through them all. So, funny thing about, oh no. Why did I almost say oh no? I think I'm starting to confuse my own projectiles with enemies, you know? I got a lot going on around me. I'm throwing axes, crosses, missiles. The whips are going everywhere. I think I'm really, for a second, thinking that I'm getting run into. Like when they all shoot at once, it's just... I feel like I can't even see my own character. Like, right there. Oh my god. I'm just glad the lightning doesn't strike on me. Although it's pretty subtle. Alright, here come big bats, little bats, just a bunch of bats. Yeah, I think we're okay. Oh, big mummy. We're pushing him back with the crosses. And the holy missiles. The missiles of God. Ah! Okay. We were not pushing him with the missiles as much as I thought we were. Getting a little cluttered again. All right, we're okay. See, we're okay. It's perfectly fine. That got a little dicey, actually. Oops, I almost got real cocky there. How close are we to freaking Axe, dude? Come on. Level 6. I guess. Oh, literally just Bible and Axe can be upgraded so long. Yeah, this pickup range is definitely nice for this scenario. We are rapidly approaching only being able to pick up or level up and grab coins and food, which is funny. Especially because we heal pretty well. And we're there. And we did it. There we go. Now it's coin time, baby. Now it's big coin time. Yeah, get out of here, plants. You trying to trap me in here? With what? You jerks? You're nothing to me. Uh-oh. Coin bag. Coin bag fever. Hey, who's got a chest for me? I'd love a chest at the moment. Let's just stand there. I don't even have to worry about you. I can just sit here and watch you perish. You have a lot of health, sure, but you move slow and I got lightning. I'm basically a god. Just gonna walk over here and let the whips take care of you for a second. There, see? Unzi. Half cleared. Oh, more mummies. Whatever, man. You know, I don't think I've, So we finished up Rabbids the other day. Mario Rabbids Sparks of Hope. I don't think I've gotten a really good chance to talk about that, especially now that it's been over for a couple days. That was, So the first one, I think overall, I preferred the first game. The first game had, mechanically, was a little bit more fun. And there are some things that I wish one game had that the other one did, and the other one had that the other one did. So, like, for example, I was surprised that, So the first one, the enemies could do things like bounce off each other and hit you in the same, and, like, you know, move around the map the same way that you could. But they couldn't in this one, but they were still restricted to some rules, such as, who are the deaths, by the way? Such as if they shoot, it ends their turn, so I could always take it. It was a lot of figuring out what rules that still applied to them that applied to you, and you could take advantage of that, which was kind of neat. But I don't know, it felt like it was some odd changes sometimes like that. And overall, I felt like the first game was actually based around, like, you want to try and figure out proper flanks, like an XCOM game, sort of. And you want to figure out, can I just get chicken instead? It's going to give me bag coin, I know that. But the second one just didn't really feel like it was as focused on the flanking aspect. I mean, like, I had characters who could overcome partial cover pretty easily, you know? So it was kind of like, well, just do that instead. I do think the sparks were a really neat change and could give you that sort of, instead of the weapons being imbued with certain types of damage, and that was if you critted, it made it so that you could imbue them with any type of damage, and it wasn't necessarily based on a crit, but it had a cooldown. That was neat. And of course, some of the other items, like just being able to, like, I don't know, stun them for a turn, or hit a certain area with a certain kind of element, that was nice for sure. And overall, I think I felt that the first game's final boss fight was, like, it was actually hard, and it was, like, a little unnecessarily hard, where it was just, like, on some turns, if you moved, Bowser would just blast the shit out of you. Everything in that first round did, like, fire damage, which meant that you would if one of them could flank you, you would essentially be screwed out of your cover, and then they would all just kill your one guy or whatever. Like, that sucks. Like, it just didn't feel good. The rest of that fight was just sort of like normal, but that first part was like, you get hit with any kind of fire and you're screwed. The second game's boss fight, though, was fantastic, in my opinion. The fact that you got to use all of your characters was really cool, in my opinion. That was really neat. I really quite liked that. I didn't really use a lot of them throughout the game, which is like, that was, I guess, the other side of that token was that you started with all but two characters, which is wild in a game where you eventually have nine characters to choose from. And I had honestly really wished that they had implemented being able to use a fourth character. Like, you could in, like, you know, some of those certain fights, like boss fights or the fights near the end, but like, it was, they were locked in, you couldn't choose. Like, I really wish they had let you choose to play with a fourth character sometime. Like, that would have been really nice, because I probably would have been able to use some of the other characters a little more. I tried to use Bowser when he first joined, and I think I had used Luigi for a little while, swapped him out for someone. Who was that? I used Rabbit Mario at the start too. I think I tried things a little bit at the beginning, but just I don't think I really tried Peach very much or Rabbit Peach. And then once Edge came in, I was like, I felt like Edge was one of the best characters. I kept using her for a long time. Who was my squad? It was Edge. It was Luigi again. And who else? What was it? I don't remember now. Curse my terrible memory. I'm trying to think based off of what I had my party doing. So Luigi was the long range. Edge was like the... Oh, it was Rabid Rosalina. Oh, I'm sorry. You do get three characters. I forgot. So you get three additional characters. So you start with six, but that's still fucking crazy, man. Yeah, because Rabid Rosalina could break cover. Like, of course I was using her. Rabid Rosalina could break cover. Edge could ignore partial cover and could hit multiple people. And Luigi could just hit from pretty far away, and I made him... my elemental bitch, so to speak. Yeah, he was much superior. And Rabbit Rosalina could like stasis people, so you could put people like Edge in more dangerous situations and then just freeze all the enemies around and be like done. So it just felt like there wasn't a whole lot of motivation to use a lot of other characters. I really liked some of the newer characters. Bowser was okay. We're kind of owning it right now, huh? Is it even worth picking up the chest? I mean, like, not really, right? I do feel like sometimes, not to, like, diss the game, sometimes you just get near the end of a run and you're just kind of like, I'm going, I guess. I'm just doing still. I'm just doing my thing. And no one's gonna stop me. We don't have the clock, so I can't actually beat the Reaper, but.
Are you gonna stand still for a second and rub my eyes? Because I had a problem one time when I finished playing, but I didn't think I was blinking.
I forget which one that was now, but I actually, like, I quit recording, and I was like, why did my eyes hurt? And I, like, went to blink a few times, and I was like, now they feel a little better. Were they just dry? And I'm like, did I just stare at the, like, screen for, like, the past 20 minutes? Just, like, I don't think it was when I was, like, having an easy time on, like, I am right now. Like, I think it was one that it was a struggle to a certain extent. and I was having to like move around a bit. Anyways, this one looks like it's gonna be a dub, probably. Place your bets, don't forget. And you know what? Don't forget to like and subscribe. And comment your favorite pizza chain. And I'll make a tier review someday about pizza chains based on cost and value of pizza, which I guess is like sort of just saying the same thing. This shit pretty good. I feel like if you get 3+ special like enhanced items, you're gonna win that round. I wonder if I just never got cross to level 8, and maybe getting cross to level 8 will unlock whatever it combines with, or maybe it's something completely different that I just need to like find randomly. Might as well grab that, huh? I mean, it's clearly going to be a bag of quiche, but whatever. We're 6 seconds from the end. We might as well. Okay. Here he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. He go! Boy, he came out of like a right field, man. I was not expecting him. Thunder Loop, the MVP, 4 mil damage. Damn. By like a lot. Whoa. Beat a total of... What? Evolve the whip, getting 500 coins. Defeat a total of 100,000 enemies. Unlock Croce. What's Croce do? Oh, he's got a cross. Starts with 1 revival. Gains 1 more revival at level 33. Yo, that's neat. All right, well, next time I guess we'll do Porecho. Sur Clerici. Mortaccio. Croci. Croci Freddo. So Italian. Anyways, that was Porta Ladana. Arca Ladana, we have not beaten with yet. We should probably try and go back into like Antonio and Imelda at some point. Yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Streams are on Thursday, Wednesday, and Fridays at 8 p.m. EST and Sunday at 3 p.m. EST. Every other day, I try to do a vampy like this. And maybe I had an idea. Had a small idea for another series like that, like this. But I want to do more of this first. Then maybe try that out. I want to unlock all the characters and play them through at least once. And then maybe try the other series a little bit. But we'll see. We'll see. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you guys later.